Driver's license last week. It's always one step forward and three steps back.
How I make bracelets using a bead spinner. First, you're going to want to pick out your colours. It doesn't matter how many colours you pick, but the amount. It's easier for the hook to pick up the beads when there's more. The amount I had was on the lower side, but it works better if you do have more. Then you want to cut your string. I recommend using very stretchy string. Then grab your hook and put the string through the hole. Make sure that your needle isn't touching the base of the bead spinner, because it won't pick up any beads and it'll scratch your spinner. You want to put it just touching the beads and then spin the bead spinner with your other hand. Then you just pull the beads down onto your string. Then you just repeat this. And every time the hook starts filling up with beads, you just pull the beads onto the string. Then you'll end up with something like this. You then want to tie the bracelet 3 to 5 times. I like to stretch it throughout to make sure it's durable. Then I just cut the excess string off. I do one final stretch to make sure it's durable enough to sew. And that's how I make bracelets with a bead spinner.
It's brutal out here. Guess you didn't cheat, but you're still a traitor. I got my driver's license last week. It's always one step forward and three steps back.
Use the sound if you make bracelets. Show us your first bracelet, your favorite bracelet, your least favorite bracelet, the bracelets that everyone wants to steal when they see, and lastly, your colorful bracelet.
Don't get lost, 'cause I'm waiting. Summer feelings awaiting, boy. You and me is more than 100 miles. You and me is more.
My Gucci on. I go wear my Louis Vuitton, but even with nothing on, bet I made you look. Yeah, I look good in my Versace dress, but I'm hotter when my morning.
lost cause I'm waiting. Summer feelings are waiting, boy. You and me is more than 100 miles.
Use the sound if you make bracelets. Show us your first bracelet, your favorite bracelet, your least favorite bracelet, the bracelets that everyone wants to steal when they see, and lastly, your colorful bracelet.
When I met you in the summer, to my heartbeat sound, we fell in love as the leaves turned brown. And we could be together, baby.
Yeah, you're smiling in my face and rip the brakes out my car. Gave you all I had and you tossed it in the trash. You tossed it in the trash, yes you did. To give me all your love is all I ever ask. Cause what you don't understand is I...
I spent $100 on beads, and this is what I got. Lots of cool colors for spring and summer. Now for the charms. Here's the pearls I got. Oops, I got it too small. It came broken, but I can fix it. All of our packaging materials. Shiny. Our little scoop.
My beads came in. I am so excited to make some bracelets so I can sell. Then, I will be making this small business, so I would really appreciate some support, not forcing.
You're staying, you're gone. Sorry, wasn't sure about you, but I'm going to tip towards gone. So, gone. One of you two has been rejected. Who do you think it is? Wrong, it's you. You're
You tried to break my heart, oh that breaks my heart. That you thought you ever had it, no you ain't from the start. Hey, I'm glad you're back with your bitch, I mean who would wanna hide this? I will never ever 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 be your side chick.
This is how I make bracelets using a bead spinner. First you're gonna wanna pick out your colors. It doesn't matter how many colors you pick, but the amount. It's good to have a lot of beads in there so it's easier for the hook to pick them up. You can see my amount is actually kind of on the lower side, and all it does is it just takes longer to do. Here's the string I use. I really like this string. It's strong and super stretchy, like it says. After that, you're gonna wanna take your hook and then you're gonna wanna thread your string to the eye of the needle. There's a couple ways of doing this. You could have it face down, make sure you know the actual hook isn't scraping against the bowl. You kind of want to have it just slightly up so it catches on those beads. I personally like the other way, which I'm doing right now, which is just having it on the side. I feel like it catches my beads faster, but it's all personal preference. I usually work in little amounts of times and take little inches of beads and push it down in my hand, but after you get a good amount of beads, you're going to want to push it off the hook and onto the string. I didn't pay attention and this happened. It was so sad. All right, trying it again. We're gonna take the string off the hook. We're just gonna slide it out
I actually wanted to add some pearls to this, and then after a couple pearls, I went ahead and I measured it, and we always make sure all our bracelets are the same size. I tie it off. I tie it about 3 to 5 times. I make sure I stretch it out too, so it's not gonna break. Then I go ahead and cut it. I actually really like how it turned out. I actually also have an automatic bead spinner, so if you guys wanna see how that works, let me know.
Why do people call small businesses overpriced? But big businesses can sell the exact same product for 10 times more and people don't complain. Big businesses have thousands of workers. Small businesses like mine only have one. Yet I still get thousands of comments every day saying my products are overpriced.
Do you find the left hand side? Pass the dodgy find the left hand side. It's a good body.